It's time for the Writer's Block. I'm Jenny Carlson here from the Oklahoman, and I'm joined by Cedric Golden from the Austin American-Statesman. Hey, Ced, how's it going?
I'm great, Jen. What's going on?
Well, there's a lot of talk going around my neck of the woods, and I think your neck of the woods, about the NFL Combine, which obviously is wrapped up in Indianapolis, but now all the talk coming out of there about players, where they should be drafted. What struck you, Cedric, as you were watching all of that go on and now all of the post-combine talk that's out there?
Well, the sheer speed of some of the big guys kind of struck me, but it does every year. It's great. I think besides coming out of the Texas camp, their linebacker Gary Johnson ran 4.4 and made himself a little bit of money. The safety / cornerback Chris Boyd was asked by one of the personnel guys, do you have two testicles? I don't know what that means.
I try not to think about what that means, Cedric. I'm trying to put that one out of my head altogether.
I guess he just wanted to know. So that was really strange. It reminds me when they asked Dez Bryant if his mom was a prostitute. Remember that?
I do. I mean,
so some of those guys should just be thrown out of there. That's just dumb. I mean, it's not about any external crap. Let's just talk about football. But Kyler Murray not working out drew some criticism from former league GM Charlie Casserly. Kyler, you go be Kyler. Don't worry about the haters. Your pro timing day's coming up. You're going to put on a show, and you're going to go in the first round, and I bet the Arizona Cardinals are probably going to take you. So I wouldn't worry about the haters. I would just play my game, and if people have a problem with him not working out, okay, that's their problem. He's a dynamic talent. He's put it on film, and he's going to put on a show for the scouts in Oklahoma.
Yeah, I think so too, Cedric. And, you know, I wasn't really all that taken aback by the fact that Kyler Murray didn't work out at the NFL Combine. You know, in fact, I sort of thought that would be the way it would go. You know, here's a guy that was considering, do I go play baseball? Do I do this NFL thing? Do I try to do both? You know, I'm not sure that in that time where he was trying to make that decision, if he was 100%, you know, in NFL Combine, NFL workout mode. So to give himself a little extra time to get ready for those cone drills. Now, he could go out, you know, roll out of bed and run a fast 40 because he's fast, but you want to show off all of that. He'll have a chance to do that at Oklahoma on their pro day. That's next Wednesday, March 13th. So that'll be a highly anticipated, highly watched thing. I thought it was a little bit odd, the comments from Charlie Casserly, Cedric, merely from the standpoint of, you know, the comments being made that he didn't interview well. And, you know, I have never really heard anything that would make me believe that, you know, he wasn't able to look at, you know, do the board work that they talk about or talk to teams in a way that, you know, would come off professionally. So maybe he did have a couple bad interviews with teams. I'd just be surprised if it was, you know, every team, like we sort of heard from Charlie Casserly. I don't think it's going to dissuade many teams from looking seriously at him. He played great at Oklahoma, obviously won the Heisman. To me, Cedric, the thing that stood out about him at the Combine was the fact that his measurables were maybe bigger and higher than we thought. And I don't know how much that changes things when you can officially put him 5'10 and an eighth, but I think for some teams that was important. Crazy, but important.
What about the 207? That surprised me. I was like, he's bigger than I thought he was. And I haven't seen him in a while. I hope he hadn't gotten fat, but 207 was surprising. I didn't think that he was that stocky. But at the end of the day, Jen, if what's going to happen is when you're facing a pass rush, do you really think that the defensive end is going to beat his blocker and then put a microphone in your face, or do you think he's going to try to tackle you? Let's not overcomplicate this thing, man. This is football.
Yeah.
He's a smart kid.
Yeah.
His grades were decent. He's never had any problems off the field. He's a competitor. Just because he's not Chatty Cathy doesn't mean that he can't diagnose an NFL defense. Didn't this kid just win the Heisman Trophy, or am I suffering from some kind of amnesia? He's a great football player. He's going to translate to the next level. I think he's going to be a Cardinal, and I think he's going to do some really good things. Is he going to be great? I don't know. That's a small sample size, but I know that he can play in that league. We've seen him for many years. He's a stud horse. He's not very big, but we know he can play football.
Yeah, and you know, I think it bears a couple things that I think about as it relates to his football abilities. We saw it, you saw it, Cedric, I saw it. Anybody that watched Oklahoma, there were times when you watched Kyler Murray make plays, whether it was waiting on receivers to get open. There's a play he made in the West Virginia game that stands out in my mind where he held the ball and moved the pocket and waited for, I think it was almost 7 seconds. I mean, that's the kind of thing that he's waiting on that, and then he has the ability to buy time for receivers to break open, to find a spot that he can get the ball to them, and then he did. You know, I think, too, that speed, that elusiveness, you know, he did not get hit a lot this last year, and to me, that was something that if you're an NFL exec and you're thinking about maybe taking Kyler Murray in a high draft position, you know, yes, he's smaller. Yes, that's a concern, but he threw over big offensive linemen and he eluded really fast defensive guys on a regular basis. I know they get faster. I know they get bigger in the NFL, but the film that's out there on Kyler Murray would lead you to believe he's a guy that can do those things on a pretty regular basis. So will he be number one? I don't know. Will he be first round? It seems like that is where this is definitely heading, a guy that's going to be taken top 10, even with some of those concerns out there. I wonder, it makes me think back a couple years ago about Adrian Peterson. That name springs to mind when I think about all the hubbub about him, and there was talk, you know, should he be taken? Where's he, you know, falling? Teams had concerns. He turns out to be one of the best running backs in the NFL in the last decade or so. So how much stock you put in those concerns, we'll see. But definitely a lot yet to be talked about as it relates to the NFL draft, which is still over a month away. We'll have a lot more to talk about as it relates to that.